Mislim, da nam mora biti dovolj tega, da se nas dela krive tako, da se nam nalaga dolg prejšnjih generacij. Dovolj dolgo smo bili material, iz katerega so gnetli tuje sanje, naj bojo to sanje partizanov ali njihovih žrtev. Dovolj nam mora biti vampirjev, ki živijo od tega, da nas delajo krive in izterjujejo od nas tuje dolgove. In danes je, če ne končam poetično, mislim, en sam kov, lesen kov, skupaj s česnom, ki bo pokončal vse vrste vampirjev. Liberalno-demokratična stranka. Hvala.
Two days before the election, there was a big round table with all the candidates, 20 of them, I don't know how much.
Samo, jaz bi ponovil tukaj Churchillov paradoks. Je najslabši vseh možnih sistemov, težava je v tem, da ni, kot kaže izkustvo, nobenega ostalega, ki bi bil boljši.
A right wing, naive good guy, but basically an idiot, made a fatal mistake, which everybody remembered. Not even a mistake, a kindness. Namely, as usual, as you can imagine, I talked quite a lot, too much. And then this guy wanted to censor me friendly and turned to me, this was all live, big debate, Central TV, blah, blah.
Te stvari. In kljub temu, da mi je kolega Žižek zelo simpatičen, gotov ima on najvišji inteligenčni kocient tu med nami, o tem sem prepričan, vendar je pa on toliko danes govoril kot polovico te naše mize. No, to je uvod.
Listen, we all know that your IQ is twice as all of us others combined. But nonetheless, could you let us a little bit to talk? But everybody remember that, you know. You see, even they admit that he is the bright guy and so on. I remember then, you know, after it was over, when the lights went off, no, the cameras went off. All other candidates started to shout at this guy, like, are you idiot? Are you crazy? Because then I jumped up immediately and almost got elected.
When I first visited the States, I was shocked by your toilets here. Romanticism onwards. There was the idea of so-called European Trinity. Anglo-Saxon economy, French politics, German metaphysics, poetry, philosophy, as the basic, how to put it, spiritual stances of Europe. Sorry, that's it. French politics revolutionary, shit should disappear as soon as possible. Anglo-Saxon American, let's be pragmatic, blah, blah, blah. German metaphysic poetry inspection, you inspect, you reflect on your shit. So isn't it totally crazy that in a vulgar common phenomenon like that, you find certain differences which you cannot truly account in any functional terms, but you have to evoke all this. I mean, you claim, okay, I'm out of ideology at the conference, post-ideological era, then you go to the toilet, produce shit, you are up to your shit, or how do you put it in ideology, no? Believes what today? Oh, I think this is an interesting question, much more complex than it may appear. The first myth to be abandoned, I think, is the idea that we live in a cynical era where nobody believes, no values, and so on, and that there were sometimes more traditional where people still believed, relied on some substantial notion of belief, and so on, and so on. I think it's today that we believe more than ever. And as Faller develops it in a nice ironic way, the ultimate form of belief for him is deconstructionism. Why? Again, I'm going back to that question of quote marks, no? Like, look how it functions, deconstructionism, in its standard version, already at the texture of style. Like, you cannot find one text of Derrida without A, all of the quotation marks, and B, all of these rhetorical distanciations. Like, I don't know, to take an ironic example. If somebody like Judith Butler were to be asked, what is this? She would never have said, this is a bottle of tea. She would have said something like, if we accept the metaphysical notion of language identifying clearly objects and taking all this into account, then may we not, she likes to put it in this rhetorically, risk the hypothesis that in the conditions of our language game, this can be said to be a bottle of tea and so on and so on. So it's always this need to distanciate. It goes even for love, like nobody almost dares to say today, I love you. It has to be, as a poet would have put it, I love you, or some kind of a distance. But what's the problem here? The problem is that, why this fear? Because I claim that when the ancients directly said, I love you, they meant exactly the same. All these distanciations were included. So it's we today who are afraid that if we were to put it directly, I love you, that it would mean too much. We believe in it. I learned in the high school?
What?
English and Russian. You know why Russian?
Why?
It's so disgusting, the reasoning behind it. Because all my friends, most of my friends took either French or German as a second language.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, my idea was, you know, there was a Cold War, two superpowers. Isn't it good to play it safe? Whoever wins will speak their language. There were three levels of dissidents. The first, in theory. I mean, if you dealt with theory or whatever, or writings. The first level was where you allowed to teach. This was the first level of exclusion. The second level were, are you allowed to publish books? The third level was, are you allowed to get a job at all in your domain? And the fourth level, if you score, you are arrested or whatever, no? I was between the second and third. My God, I was unemployed. It was humiliating. I had to, my parents, I was 27 and my parents supported me, my God. Then for 2 years, it was that humiliating job at the Central Committee. They knew that I am not an idiot and that I will probably succeed. So they were afraid that I would simply move abroad and succeed there. This would then be bad for, you know, another victim who wasn't allowed to make a career in Slovenia. So they want me to vegetate on the margin, but there in Slovenia. It was, in a way, an intelligent move. But they didn't know it, that the way they did it, they make it even easier for me to move abroad.
You.
Okay. But you don't you have, no, yeah. Roger.
I have
a perfect. Give him seven, it's okay. Oh, sorry.
Okay.
Okay, gracias. This is Disney.
Yeah,
ah, my God. I thought this would be some kind of old building, you know, with Perón and so, not
oh.
Perón, with Borges and so on. Oh, my
yeah,
God. Yeah. Oh my God, I didn't like the way that guy looked at me, you know. It's already an idiot coming there. I hate this. Let's move there. I really hate this.
What do you hate?
I hate when I think that idiot, friendly person, recognized me, and I hate this because then they it's terror.
They descend on you?
Oh my God, okay. To whom do I put it to?
Flora.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So did you ever expect this to have all these fans?
No, but that's what I really hate this. I mean, I cannot tell you how much I hate it.
You don't love it just a little bit?
No. I think people are easy. This is horrible.
You see all these creeps here, this is horrible. Who's that hysterical woman?
She's a fan, Slavoj.
Yeah, but, I mean, what is she doing here? She should go up there and wait in line. I mean, not annoy me here.